of Seaside is joining in on the nationwide call to act today. We have team coverage tonight of demonstrators who say they're seeking justice for Trayvon Martin in their own way. Action News reporter Jacqueline Mazur has more in our top story.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Dozens are gathering in Seaside remembering the fallen 17-year-old Trayvon Martin, who was fatally shot in late February of last year.
I think it's a shame that a precious child is gone because somebody else was afraid that carried a gun.
Local church leaders organized Saturday's vigil. They hope to urge the Justice Department to open an investigation into a civil rights case against George Zimmerman, the man who was acquitted in a Florida courtroom this past week.
When the verdict came back not guilty, I felt a sense of betrayal by the court system.
Trayvon's rights were violated. He had the right to go to the store and safely make his way home without interruption. And as we know, the interruption led ultimately to his death.
Advocates say the vigil is an opportunity for the community to come together and reflect on Trayvon's death, to get motivated and fight for the right to peacefully protect yourself and your property.
Demonstrators tell us today's vigil is also a push to repeal the Stand Your Ground laws.
It almost seems like Stand Your Ground law is a license to kill people who you don't want in your neighborhood or who you don't like.
A Stand Your Ground law gives individuals the right to use reasonable force to defend themselves without requiring the person to leave a potentially dangerous situation. A Florida jury found Zimmerman not guilty of second-degree murder and manslaughter on July 13th. Zimmerman says he shot the teen in self-defense. In Seaside, Jacqueline Mazur, KSBW, Action News 8.